You know who he's coming for?
Me and you.
Prepared people.
That's right.
Yes, prepared people.
You know where he's going to take you? To heaven, which is a prepared place for prepared people.
That's right.
Unprepared people can't go there.
That's right.
You, if you're unprepared, you can't go.
No, that's right. True. Amen.
Wouldn't it be a terrible thing to miss heaven?
Amen.
I don't want anybody to miss heaven.
Couldn't be anything worse.
But you got to be prepared to get there.
Yeah, that's right,
brother. Are y'all prepared tonight?
Amen. Hallelujah.
If you're not prepared,
get prepared.
I like what Brother One told John Sunday. Don't know about tomorrow, but I know today. Amen.
Amen.
Today.
Right now.
Today.
This very moment.
Don't put it off. Amen. Don't put off. Tomorrow. You may not be here. I may not be here. We may not be here tomorrow.
Right.
We may be gone. Who knows? Even if Jesus doesn't come and we go on, we're still gone.
Amen. That's right.
We're still gone, right?
Yeah, still the end of the world.
People worry about the rapture. Well, if you die, that is your rapture. You're gone. Just make sure that you go to the right place. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Y'all excited?
Amen.
What are you excited about?
Jesus.
You better be excited about Jesus. Amen. People get excited about a lot of things. Brother Will asked me, he said, what are we going to learn tonight? And I said, well, what can you tell me one thing about the power of God?
and so
he said, I know a scripture. I know that scripture. And so, but anyway, I said, we're going to try to learn a few things about the power of God tonight. Amen.
Amen.
So let's look at the power of God in light of God's word. Amen. That's the only way you're going to know for sure. The power of God. 1 Corinthians. I want to go there just for a couple of minutes. In 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians. In 1 Corinthians 1:18. 1 Corinthians 1:18. 1 Corinthians 1:18. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians 1:18. Thank you, Jesus. Do you need a Bible? You need a Santa Biblia? Okay. I got one out here if you need it. Okay? All right. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 18.
Amen.
This is a powerful, powerful verse.
Amen.
It says, listen. It says, for the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness.
Yeah, that's right.
But unto us which are saved, it is what?
Power.
The power of God. The preaching of the cross. Number one, we don't have much preaching left anymore in America. There's not much preaching left in America. We have a lot of teaching, but we have very little preaching. Vast difference between preaching and teaching. It says Jesus started out teaching and preaching. Takes all of it. And so, but what, you're not really preaching until you're preaching about the victory that took place on Calvary. Amen?
Amen.
The cross.
Amen.
We keep that one up there. It kind of hangs a little crooked. You know, I try to straighten it up and it still wants to hang a little crooked. That's all right. Praise God. Cross may be crooked, but the one who hung on it was straight. Amen?
Amen.
Woo! Hallelujah. And so you get straight. You know, you turn right and go straight. That's your direction. Somebody wants to know direction, say turn right and go straight.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Get right and turn right and get right and then go straight on with Jesus. Praise God. And so it says that the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness.
Yes.
Well, the Bible says you're not to call any man a fool.
That's
right?
That's right.
But when God calls you a fool, you're a fool. If God calls you a fool, you're a fool, right? And so he said it is foolishness only to those who are going to perish. So we know that some are going to perish.
Yes.
Some are going to perish.
That's right.
You know what happens when something perishes? Okay, you buy this, you go down and buy you some fruit or some vegetables. And you don't eat them, you don't consume them. They just lay there, and soon they begin to what? Perish. They perish. After a season, they perish. Well, okay, what can you do with the perished goods? They're not fit for consumption, so you throw them away, right?
Yep.
And so there's people today that are perishing. We used to sing that song, "Rescue the Perishing, Care for the Dying." And where today are we caring for those that are perishing? Rescuing those that are perishing. You know that I believe what I'm fixing to tell you, that everybody that doesn't know the Lord really is crying out in a different way. I used to teach school. The first kid you know is a kid who is the biggest troublemaker in class. Why? They're crying out for attention. Amen. If you got two children or three children or four children or 27, the one who needs the most attention is going to be the kid that gets in the most trouble.
Yes.
Right? Why? They've got to have that attention. Mm-hmm. There's no two kids ever been made alike. I don't care. Every child has got a different personality. We've got a different personality.
Yes, sir.
And when we cut up and act up, we are crying out in some way for some attention. Everybody wants attention from Jesus. Everybody's got a testimony. You got a testimony. You got a testimony. You got a testimony. You got a testimony. We've all got a testimony. Something we want to tell the world. Do we ever tell them? You know the greatest testimony is? Hey, have you ever done this? Just walk up to somebody you don't even know and say, "Sir, I don't know you, but could I just share my testimony to you? Ma'am, I don't even know you, but could I just share my testimony about Jesus?" You know, it'd probably blow people out of the water. Who is this person that's going to tell me about their salvation experience? You see, I can tell mine. I've told it hundreds of times. Do you have a testimony of your encounter with Jesus? I've had people say, "Well, I just grew up in church." I don't want to hear that.
Right.
I want to hear about when you met Jesus.
Amen.
When did you
yes.
meet Jesus?
Yes.
See, I know when I met Jesus.
Right.
You could line up every devil in hell and say, "You're not born again." I say, "You're a liar. You're a liar. You're just like your father. You're a liar." Because I know that I have met Jesus, the Son of God.
Yes.
I had an encounter with Jesus.
Changed
my life. And my life has been changed since then. And my life will be changed until I leave here, praise God. Why? It was changed how? For the better.
Amen.
It was changed for the better. It was changed for the better, praise God. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord. You feeling better? You look better than you did when you came in here a while ago. Hallelujah. She came in here a while ago. She was sicker than a dog. Weak, sickly, burning up with a fever. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. She said, "I got to go feed Savants and I'll be back." I said, "Only if you feel like it, amen." Hallelujah. So you feel like it.
Hey, I got to testify.
Oh, you want to testify?
Praise the Lord.
I'm sure it hurts. See, that's exactly what we're talking about, right?
Yes.
I'm talking exactly about a testimony.
Amen.
She walks in and says, "You feel all right? I got a testimony." So let's listen to her testimony. Amen.
Amen.
Last night, is this on? Did I turn it on? Yeah.
Maybe come up a little bit, Randy, please.
Last night I was going to school, and all of a sudden it was a pain sharper. It was very, very sharp pain. I had not felt in a very long time. And it went up my neck and into my head. And the pressure began in my eyes. And I did everything that I could possibly do. I would shift, I would change, I would do this, I would do that, trying to get it to calm down a little bit. And I couldn't shake it. And I was praying the entire time, and and it was funny because, you know, you're supposed to praise the Lord even in the midst of the storm. So here I am. I'm praising the Lord. I'm saying, "God, this is only for a moment. 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 I praise you and I glorify you. This is only for a moment." And so last night, I had an exam today, and so I was studying, but I'm looking at the pages and my eyes are, you know, I'm crying, my eyes are going, and I'm just like, forget it, it's not happening. So I went to bed and I'm like, okay, maybe, you know, I'm going to go to sleep and everything's going to be okay, and I'm going to wake up tomorrow morning and everything's going to be fine.
Woman of faith.
And so here I am, and I wake up in the morning, and the first thing I do is run to the bathroom, and everything came up. And it was constant the whole day. It was constant the whole day. I asked my husband to pray for me. He prayed for me. I was praying the whole day, and I was praising the Lord the whole day, and I was just praising and saying, Lord, this is only for a moment. This is only for a moment. This is only for a moment. And but, you know, when you're in the midst of that, I mean, I turned to my husband, and I said, can you chop my head off? Because it was painful. Anoche, en la noche, empezó un dolor cuando yo iba para la escuela de que yo no había tenido en largo tiempo, y subió por mi nuca y empezó la presión detrás de mis ojos, y era como un dolor de cabeza que yo no había tenido en largo, largo tiempo. Y pues la palabra dice que nosotros debemos de alabarle al Señor, ¿no? Entonces, pues en las buenas y en las malas, ahí estaba yo, te alabo Señor, esto solamente por un momento, solamente por un momento. Y pasó todo, y me movía de un lado y me movía del otro, y constantemente alabando al Señor, alabando al Señor. Y llego a la casa, yo tenía que estudiar porque hoy tenía un examen. So, estoy tratando de ver las palabras y no puedo ver las palabras porque mis ojos están llorando, porque mi cabeza no... tenía el dolor muy, era un dolor muy feo, muy feo. Bueno, entonces me voy a decir, no, pues me voy a dormir, voy a acostarme, alabado sea el Señor, el día de mañana me voy a sentir bien, es solamente por un momento. Me levanto en la mañana y lo primero que hago, bueno, arreglo las cosas del niño y corro al baño porque empiezo a vomitar, porque el dolor era tan doloroso que no aguantaba yo, a mí, me di cuenta que el estómago estaba mal, me iba de lado. A mí, era un dolor feo, feo. Y todo el tiempo voy con mi esposo, le digo, ora por mí, porque esto no me gusta, por favor, ora por mí. So, aquí estamos nosotros orando, y todo el día yo fui a la escuela, hice todo lo que tenía que hacer, pero el dolor ahí. Y yo constantemente te alabo, Señor, esto es solamente por un momento, esto es solamente por un momento, esto es solamente por un momento, esto va a pasar. Yo te alabo, Señor, esto es solamente por un momento. Entonces ya fui a recoger a Savance, estaba mi esposo conmigo porque él fue a recogerme a mí para ir a recoger a Savance porque yo no quería manejar. My husband went to pick me up and then we went to go pick up Savance and because I didn't want to drive because it got to the point where, you know, it probably was not a good thing.
Probably not.
Fuimos a recoger a Savance and this my intentions were to come in and say, please pray for me. I don't think I'm coming in today. Esas eran mis intenciones. Mis intenciones eran entrar aquí al templo, decir, por favor, oren por mí. No voy a venir hoy en la noche, because, I mean, llegó al punto donde yo me di vuelta con mi esposo y le dije, ¿me puedes cortar la cabeza? I mean, el dolor era fuerte, fuerte. Yo nunca había, era un dolor fuerte. So, I came in and I tell him, and the pastor, I want to tell you, the minute that you laid hands, right where you laid hands, the pressure from my eyes left instantaneously.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Cuando el pastor puso sus manos sobre mí, en la frente, la presión que estaba sobre mis ojos se fue instantáneamente.
Thank you, Jesus.
I mean, it was gone.
Thank you,
and
Jesus.
And I was like, oh! Thank God.
Thank you, Jesus.
I was like, thank God it was only for a moment.
Thank you, Jesus.
For a moment. It was only for a moment.
Praise
and the thing is that the moments for us, you know, even it is only for a moment, really and truly. I mean, it can be, for me, it was a whole night and almost a whole day, but it was only for a moment.
Yes.
That's the amazing thing.
Somebody needed to hear that. Somebody needed to hear that.
Only for a moment.
Amen.
Somebody needed to hear that right there. If you don't get nothing else.
Sí, lo que yo les quiero decir es que fue solamente por un momento.
Yes.
Por mí el momento tardó toda una noche, quizás todo el día.
Whatever you're going through may seem like a long time, it's just a moment.
Aunque parezca que es largo tiempo, es solamente un momento. It's only a moment.
Amen.
But so my husband was cooking and I was reading the Bible to him and we were both, you know, just talking and we were reading in Romans 10. verse 11, and this is what it says. Romans 10, verse 11 says, as the scripture says, anyone who trusts in him will never be put to shame.
Amen.
Todo el que confíe en él no será jamás, jamás defraudado.
Amen.
And I was just, that right there, I actually read that like 2 days ago or 3 days ago. And that was the verse that I stood on all last night and all today.
Amen.
Nosotros leímos esto como hace dos o tres semanas, dos o tres días atrás. Y este es el versículo en el cual yo me paré toda la noche anoche y todo el día hoy, porque el dolor sí era un poco deshabilitador. I mean, te deshabilita. So, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
And thank you, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Thank
praise
you.
The Lord. Because
Amen.
It was only for a moment, and he has not put me to shame.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise you. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Sister Bianca. Amen. Pray. I made her a promise about...
Yo le hice a ella una promesa.
I don't know. I'm going to be going on 2 years now, I guess.
She says 2 años ya.
She works up here on Key Street, Cars and Credit.
Ella trabaja en Key Street in Cars and Credit.
And I said, Sister Bianca, every time I go in front of that place, I will pray for you and your family.
Y yo le dije, hermana Bianca, cada vez que yo paso enfrente de ese lugar, yo voy a...
Don't tell somebody that you're going to do something and not go through.
No,
you make, you lie. You make yourself a liar.
Vas a hacer algo a alguien y no lo hagas porque entonces te haces mentiroso.
I knew she wasn't, she's off on Wednesday, so I knew she wasn't working.
Yo sabía de que ella no trabaja los miércoles, yo sabía que ella no estaba trabajando.
But I come down through there about 8 o'clock this morning.
Pero yo paso por ahí como a las 8 de la mañana.
I don't know nothing's wrong.
Yo no sé que nada está malo.
Instead of praying a type prayer I would normally pray, I'm pleading the blood of Jesus over her.
En vez de estar orando la oración que normalmente yo hubiera orado por ella, yo pasé por ahí como eso de las 8 de la mañana.
Pleading the blood of Jesus.
Yo estaba clamando la sangre de Cristo sobre ella.
Amen. So praise God.
Amen.
See, each one of us are important.
Cada uno de nosotros somos importantes.
If one of us passes on, or,
si
or we're not in our position, our place in the kingdom,
o estamos en nuestro lugar en el reino,
then we have to make up that hedge.
Entonces alguien tiene que entrar para llenar ese vacío.
We make up that hedge by prayer.
Y nosotros hacemos eso por oración.
Stretch ourselves.
Nosotros nos estrechamos.
Amen.
Yes.
And so God wants to stretch us.
Right.
I'm in 1 Corinthians, Sister Bianca, chapter 1, and I just read 18. I'm going to 24.
Primera de Corintios.
1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 24. We're talking about the power of God.
Estamos hablando sobre el poder de Dios.
We saw in 18 where it is the preaching of the cross is the power of God.
Y vemos que la palabra de la cruz es el poder o la locura es del poder de Dios.
The Bible tells us we're supposed to have power with God.
La Biblia nos dice que nosotros debemos de tener poder con
Dios. We're supposed to have power with him, amen?
Tenemos que tener poder con él.
Well, if we're going to have power with him, where are we going to get that power?
Si nosotros vamos a tener poder con él, ¿a dónde vamos a recibir
preaching,
ese poder?
The preaching of the cross,
predicando la cruz,
is the power.
O la palabra de la cruz es el poder.
See, it's not being finished. It's already, he said,
no está siendo terminado, sino que dijo, ya terminó.
Finished.
Ya está terminado.
See, all, he, do you understand? Everybody on planet Earth.
Todo el mundo en planeta Tierra.
In the prayer of Jesus on the cross, he said, it is finished.
En la palabra de Jesucristo en la cruz, dijo, ya terminó.
You're going to think it's going to sound weird to you.
Esto se va a escuchar muy extraño para ti.
We do not have a sin problem on planet Earth.
Nosotros no tenemos problemas de pecado en planeta Tierra.
You say you're crazy.
Tú dices, tú estás loco.
No, he bore it.
No, él cargó todo.
What
eso.
We have is a sinner problem.
Lo que tenemos es el problema de pecador.
You understand the difference?
¿Tú entiendes la diferencia?
The sin was put on him.
El pecado fue puesto
he
sobre
bore
él.
Our sins.
Él cargó nuestro
Amen.
Pecado.
You see? Now,
ahora,
a sinner,
un pecador,
what happens when a sinner realizes and confesses our sin bearer?
¿Qué es lo que
we become
hace?
A saint.
Cuando nosotros un pecador confiesa,
saints, sinners.
Se vuelve un santo.
Some people say, don't call me a saint.
Algunas personas me dicen, no me digas
okay,
santo.
Okay, call you a sinner then.
Entonces te voy a decir pecador.
It's only two choices I got,
los
right?
únicos dos a escoger que tengo.
Yes. I either call you a goat or a sheep.
Te llamo un cabro o te llamo una oveja.
I mean, there's not a. This is not Monty Hall. Let's make a deal.
Este no es un juego que vamos a buscar la mejor.
We don't have a door number three.
No tenemos número tres.
It's either.
Es.
Yay.
Sí.
Or it's nay.
O no.
It's yes or no.
Es sí.
He
o
said,
no.
You're either for me.
Estás
or
por
you're
mí,
against me.
O estás en contra de mí.
You're either gathering.
Estás conmigo o te estás juntando a mí o te estás yendo.
There's not a third option.
No hay una tercera opción.
So or if we are for him.
Si nosotros estamos con él.
Then that's where the saints are.
Entonces ahí es donde están los santos.
When we're against him.
Cuando estamos en contra de él.
That's where the sinners are.
Ahí es donde están los pecadores.
And so he became the bridge. Calvary
él
actually
se volvió
became the bridge.
El puente. El Calvario se volvió el puente. Déjame enseñarte algo.
Look here. Here's what happened.
Aquí fue lo
God
que pasó.
Said there was a great gulf between God and man.
Dios dijo de que había un gran abismo
we
entre
no
el hombre y Dios. Nosotros no teníamos camino hacia él.
And all Calvary did is it bridged
lo que hizo el Calvario
that
es que
void
hizo un
in between God and man.
Ese abismo entre Dios y hombre.
That's what the cross did.
Eso es lo que hizo la cruz.
It provided a way to get to God.
Proveyó un camino para llegar a Dios que nosotros no teníamos.
That's the only way.
El único camino.
So the world only the world wants to hear there's many ways.
El mundo quiere escuchar que hay muchos caminos. No.
Sorry.
Disculpa.
Gene and I are working for this guy.
Eugenio y yo estamos trabajando por este
He's
hombre.
He's got this show dog.
Él tiene este perro.
You know what that show dog's name is?
Este perro es de que se enseña en lugares
Uno.
Para
huh? Uno.
Su nombre es Uno.
That dog thinks he's number one.
Ese perro piensa de que él es número uno.
Jesus is number one. Amen.
Jesús es número uno.
He's the only way. There's no other way.
Él es el único camino. No hay ningún otro camino.
What does the book of Acts tell us?
¿Qué es lo que nos dice el libro de Hechos?
There's no other what?
No hay ningún otro nombre. No hay ningún otro nombre.
Why couldn't there be two names?
Porque no pueden haber dos nombres.
Why couldn't it be another way?
Porque no puede haber otro camino.
I might want to believe in another way.
Yo quiero creer en otro camino.
The wrong way. It's your problem. The only one that died for your sins. That's right. Took all your sin on
you. You believe that kind of stuff?
¿Tú crees ese tipo de rollo?
Did for me, but okay.
Y'all don't believe that stuff, do you?
Ustedes no creen eso, ¿sí?
He is the only way.
Yo creo que es el único camino. ¿Tú crees
eso? Why can't we have more than one way?
¿Por qué no podemos tener más de un camino?
I mean, we got to get out of that. Old mindset. We got to come in.
Salir de esa mentalidad vieja y aceptar. Nosotros somos gente buena.
Be a good person,
lo único que tienes que hacer es ser una persona buena.
Oh, he's a door.
Él es una puerta.
Well, the door might be closed. What am I going to do then?
Bueno, y si esa puerta está cerrada, entonces ¿qué voy a hacer?
No.
Entonces vas a tocar.
What good knocking do?
Y entonces qué es lo que va a hacer si yo toco?
Says it. If you knock, it'll be what?
Dice que si tú tocas, entonces ¿qué pasará?
But,
se abrirá.
Y'all Christians talk about people like me who are lost. I'm lost.
So, ustedes cristianos hablan acerca de personas como yo, de que yo ando perdido.
So, if I'm lost,
si yo estoy
I
perdido,
need something. What do I need?
Yo
I need
algo.
To be found, right?
Yo necesito ser encontrado.
Help me, I'm lost.
Ayúdame, yo estoy perdido.
You know there's millions of people that are crying out tonight.
¿Tú sabes de que hay millones de personas que están clamando esta noche? Yo estoy perdido.
You know what I believe every Christian.
¿Sabes lo que yo creo?
Needs
todo cristiano.
To experience something in their life.
Deben de experimentar algo en su vida.
They need to experience getting lost out in somewhere.
Deberían de experimentarse perderse.
You've been
se
lost.
Perdieron en
I was
lugar.
Lost in the woods as a child.
Te has perdido. Yo me perdí en el.
What
en,
kind of feelings
yo me perdí
did
en,
you have?
En la selva. Cuando yo estaba niño,
scared,
yo tenía
fear.
Miedo. Yo tenía miedo.
Scared.
¿Cuáles son los sentimientos cuando tú te pierdes?
I get scared when I get lost in the city.
Yo me pierdo cuando me pierdo.
I can't find my way. I can't find the road. Y'all ever had that experience?
Cuando no puedo encontrar la carretera.
Fear.
Miedo.
And time just rushes, doesn't it?
Y el tiempo pasa rápidamente.
It's a terrible, you feel hopeless and helpless.
Te sientes sin esperanza y sin ayuda cuando estás perdido.
And I remember as a child.
Yo me acuerdo como cuando estaba niño.
You know who I was calling for?
¿Sabes a quién yo estaba clamando?
I was in the woods with my daddy.
Yo estaba en esta selva con mi papá.
Hey!
Hey!
Hey, Dan!
Papá!
I'm calling out for my father.
Yo estoy llamando por mi papá.
Because I'm lost.
Porque yo estoy perdido.
Did you call out for your father when you realized you were lost?
¿Tú clamaste por tu padre cuando te diste cuenta que tú estabas perdido?
Jesus, I'm lost.
Jesús, estoy perdido.
I'm lost.
Estoy perdido.
And I'm afraid.
Y tengo miedo.
I'm scared.
Tengo miedo.
You know my number one fear when I knew I was lost.
¿Sabes cuál era el miedo número uno para mí cuando yo me di cuenta que yo estaba perdido?
I was afraid of one thing.
Yo tenía miedo de una cosa.
You had that?
Yes, sir.
Is that the feelings and emotions?
Anybody else have that feeling? Tener miedo. Miedo de morir.
I was afraid.
Yo tenía miedo.
I was lost and I was afraid.
Yo estaba perdido y yo tenía miedo.
Because you know why I was afraid?
¿Y sabes por qué yo tenía miedo?
I knew if I died in that lost state,
porque yo sabía de que si yo me moría perdida o perdido, entonces yo me iba a ir al infierno.
I knew I'd go to hell.
Yo sabía de que yo me iba a ir al infierno. Yo no quería irme al infierno.
But yet I didn't want to surrender.
Pero no me quería entregar a Jesús tampoco.
I didn't want to confess Jesus.
No quería confesar a Jesús.
Wanted to do my own thing.
Quería hacer mi propia cosa.
Even if it cost me my soul, but
aunque me iba a costar mi alma, pero yo no quería que me costara mi alma.
Does all this kind of sound familiar?
Todo esto se escucha familiar.
See, it doesn't just affect us.
No solamente nos afecta a nosotros.
Every person on planet Earth.
Cada persona en planeta Tierra.
That has heard about this preaching of this gospel of the cross.
Predicado de este evangelio de la cruz.
The Holy Spirit
did something
when they heard it. El Espíritu Santo
hizo algo cuando lo escucharon.
Just like he did with us.
Así como lo hizo con nosotros.
He planted a seed. That
gospel planted a seed.
Now,
ahora,
we have eaten of the tree.
Hemos comido del árbol.
Of the fruit.
De la fruta.
Of the knowledge.
Del conocimiento.
Of good and evil.
De lo bueno y lo malo.
Now we have no excuse. We
ahora
know
no tenemos excusa. Sabemos,
right,
sabemos lo que es correcto y lo que es incorrecto.
We have now tasted.
Hemos saboreado
of that tree
de ese árbol
of knowledge,
de conocimiento.
Good
bueno
and evil
y malo.
Right?
Correcto.
And now we can never say,
y ahora nunca podemos decir no sabía.
Nobody ever told me.
Nadie nunca me dijo.
Every person you ever witnessed.
Cada persona con quien tú has testificado o has testificado acerca de JESUS
and the finished work of Calvary,
y el trabajo completo del Calvario,
they can never stand before God.
Nunca se pueden parar en frente de Dios.
Say, I didn't know.
Y decir yo no supe.
They can't say I didn't know.
No lo pueden decir.
They do know.
Sí,
because
saben,
you told them.
Porque tú les dijiste.
But you can't save them.
Pero tú no los puedes salvar.
You cannot save them.
Tú no los puedes salvar.
That is a work of the Holy Spirit.
Este es un trabajo del Espíritu
you can
Santo.
Pray for them,
tú puedes orar por
them
ellos, les puedes exhortar.
You can have compassion.
Puedes tener compasión.
And all those things,
y todas esas cosas,
them,
pero no les puedes salvar.
The Bible says,
la Biblia dice que ningún hombre
Jesus
puede llamar a Jesús
Lord,
Señor,
excepto
por el Espíritu Santo de Dios.
Takes the Holy Spirit.
Se toma el Espíritu Santo.
God said the
Dios
Holy Spirit
dijo el Espíritu
is going
Santo
to reveal
va a revelar
the knowledge of
el conocimiento
Jesus
de Jesús
that we might be saved
para que nosotros amen seamos salvos.
Hallelujah. So that's the power of God.
Ese es el poder de Dios.
And in 24 it says,
y en 24 dice,
it says Christ is the power of God.
Cristo 24, poder de Dios.
Christ the power of God.
Cristo poder de Dios.
He is the power. Christ is the power.
Cristo es el poder.
Remember when Paul said, "When I'm weak, I'm what?"
¿Tú te acuerdas cuando Pablo dijo yo cuando yo estoy débil yo soy fuerte?
When I'm weak, I'm strong.
Cuando yo soy débil yo soy fuerte.
She was weak.
Ella estaba débil.
She was sick, throwing up.
Ella estaba enferma, vomitando.
She's weak.
Ella estaba débil.
But she was still strong.
Pero sigue siendo
she said,
fuerte.
I was holding on to Romans.
Porque yo me estaba agarrando de Romanos.
10:11, right?
De 10:11.
It's just going to be for a moment.
Esto va a ser por un
just
momento.
A moment.
Solamente un momento.
How long were you sick?
¿Cuánto tiempo estuviste enfermo? Un momento.
I just sit for a moment.
Yo estuve enfermo por un momento.
Just for a moment.
Nada más por un momento. No. Amén.
Had to go.
Tuvo que irse.
I was reminded of Joni Erickson Tada.
Yo me recordé de Joni Erickson
Tada. She's a quadriplegic.
Ella es cuadraplégica.
And she's got breast cancer now.
Y ahora tiene cáncer de mama.
And she said.
Y ella dijo.
God, I'm a quadriplegic now.
Señor,
I got cancer.
Soy una cuadraplégica y ahora tengo cáncer.
She said I was feeling so sorry for myself.
Dijo, yo me estaba sintiendo tan mal por mí misma.
And said the Lord told her, said it's nothing more than just a on the scale of eternity.
Es solamente y el Señor le dijo es solamente un punto en la escala de la
so
eternidad.
Whatever pain and suffering and sorrow we go through. Just kind of remember that.
Luto que nosotros pasamos es solamente un punto.
The Bible says that this life is nothing more than a vapor.
Que esta vida es solamente un vapor.
We're gone.
Y nos vamos.
Gene and I were talking about this very thing today.
Y Gene y yo estamos hablando de esto hoy.
I said, Gene, do you realize you've almost lived half of your life?
Le pregunté a Gene, oye, ¿te has dado cuenta de que tú has vivido casi ya la mitad de tu vida?
3 score and 10. And then if by reason of strength, you get a little more.
Y dice, y por razón de fortaleza recibes más.
You better hope and pray you get some strength beyond that because the Bible tells you what you're going to get is more sorrows and more heartaches and more trials.
Porque la Biblia dice de que tú vas a recibir más dolores de corazón.
Everything over those 3 score and 10.
Después de esas 30 años.
Right? Some here are over 3 score and 10.
Muchos de
that's what the Bible
aquí
says.
Han pasado más de 30
you get
años.
Strength, but you still get
recibes
the heartaches and the
pero todavía
that
vas a recibir los dolores de
you
corazón y las tribulaciones que vienen con todo ello y necesitas esa fortaleza.
I never have asked anybody this.
Nunca
so
he hecho esta pregunta. Nunca le he preguntado a alguien esto.
But I wonder, you know, we talk about when
pensar,
you turn 40.
Cuando uno se vuelve 40.
You know, they say, oh man, you're turning 40.
Dicen, ay, te vas a, ya vas
you're
a tener 40 años. Has pasado,
right?
ya te has pasado.
Just when you get 70, I wonder if there's a similar awakening like I have used my allotted 3 score and 10.
Cuando tú te te tornas 70, te pones a pensar.
I'll let y'all know in about 4 years.
Tenemos ahora en 4 años.
Glory. Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
And 2 Corinthians, you're in 1 Corinthians. Go to 2 Corinthians.
Segunda de Corintios.
Chapter 6, verse 7.
En Segunda de Corintios, capítulo 6, versículo 7.
We're talking about the power of God.
Estamos hablando del poder de Dios.
And he tells us.
Y nos dice.
That this is what the ministry is all about. You cannot have a ministry.
Que de esto se trata la, el ministerio.
If you read those first.
Este, un
ministerio.
Si sí, los primeros 6 ministros, versículos.
The whole thing is about ministry.
Todo se trata del
you
ministerio.
Cannot minister
no puedes ministrar
without the power of
sin
God.
El poder de Dios.
You can't minister.
No puedes ministrar.
You can talk about.
Tú puedes hablar.
You can do all kinds of works.
Puedes hacer todo tipo de
but
trabajo,
you cannot
pero
minister
no puedes
without
estar
the power
en ministerio
of God.
Sin el poder de Dios.
Read it.
Léelo.
First 7 verses.
Los primeros 7 versículos te dicen.
If you say, well, I'm a minister.
Tú dices, yo soy un ministro.
Well, if you're a minister
entonces,
of God,
si tú eres
you've got
un ministro
power.
De Dios, entonces tú tienes poder.
You got power with
y
God.
Si tú tienes poder de Dios, con Dios.
Listen, be leery of this.
Escucha, ten cautelo de esto.
You hear people say.
Tú escuchas a las personas decir.
God uses me in healings.
Dios me usa a mí en sanidad.
But the only thing God uses me in is bad backs.
Pero lo único que me usa es para sanar espaldas malas.
Or he might say, God uses me in healing and all I can do is I'm used in the area of hearts.
Dios me usa a mí en sanidad y a mí me usa en los corazones.
Or God uses me in healing of marriages.
O me usa a mí en la sanidad de los matrimonios.
Let me tell you something.
Déjame decirte algo.
If you got ministry, you
si
got all of it.
Ministerio, tú tienes todo.
You got everything from crown of head to sole of foot. You got everything from the outside to the inside. Praise God. Front, back, and sideways, upside down, and
todos lados.
Praise God. Amen. And the power of God says,
y el poder de Dios dice,
if you're a minister
si
of my word,
ministro de mi palabra,
you got power with God to handle any situation
poder con Dios
that
para aguantar cualquier situación que viene
Amen.
En contra.
Amen. I'll do it for you, praise God.
Amen. Amen. Yo lo hago por ti. Amen.
You have power with God.
Tú tienes poder con Dios.
Praise God. Let's go to 2 Timothy 1 and 8.
Segunda de Timoteo 1 y 8.
And 2 Timothy 1 and 8 says this.
Y segunda de Timoteo 1, 8 dice esto.
It's going to say exactly what has been used twice already here tonight.
Lo que se ha usado dos veces aquí por otras personas.
And 2 Timothy 1 and 8. 2 Timothy 1 and 8 says this.
Eso es lo que dice.
Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God.
Por tanto, no te avergüences de dar testimonio de nuestro Señor, ni de mí, preso suyo, sino participa de las aflicciones por el Evangelio según el poder de Dios.
I'm going back to your prayer request.
Regreso a la petición de tu oración.
Some of y'all were not here.
Algunos de ustedes no estaban aquí.
Prayer request tonight.
Pero la petición de ella fue
in North Korea, which is communist country,
que es un país comunista.
That the underground church, you
de
help
que
me if I get
la
to
iglesia
that,
que estaba escondida, van a públicamente orar
out in the streets,
en las calles,
and bus stations,
en
and
estaciones
all
de buses y todos lugares públicos
for 100 days, right?
Por 100 días.
100 days.
Por 100 días.
Guess what Cleveland just did?
¿Sabes lo que acaba de hacer Cleveland?
They're missing it by 99 days.
Lo están perdiendo por 99 días.
We had a day of prayer down
tuvimos
on the courthouse
un día
square
de oración,
last week, right?
La semana pasada.
One day
la
out
corte
of the year.
Un día de todo el año.
This is the belt buckle.
Este es el cinto de Pentecostés.
That's what it's called, belt buckle.
Este es el cinto de Pentecostés.
We came as a community one day.
Y nosotros entramos como comunidad un
one
solo
day
día para orar públicamente.
Have you prayed out publicly lately?
¿Tú has orado públicamente últimamente?
Go to the next time you go to a restaurant, just sit there and just
ve look. La próxima vez que tú vas a un restaurante siéntate a ver cuántas personas van a orar públicamente.
If they do that.
Si lo hacen, lo van a hacer así.
Eat.
Y a comer.
I don't want to sit with you if you ain't got guts enough to pray out loud.
Yo no me quiero sentar contigo si tú no tienes las agallas para orar en voz alta.
We went to, usually when if we go out, I don't even really like to go out on Sunday to eat, but if we go out,
si nosotros salimos a comer,
it's just me and my wife.
Es mi esposa
we
y
pray.
Yo. Nosotros oramos.
God, where you want us to go today?
Señor, ¿dónde quieres que tú nos vayamos hoy?
Sunday.
El domingo, después que nos fuimos de aquí.
Holy Ghost, tell me where to go.
El Espíritu Santo me dijo a dónde
ir. I told my wife where
yo le dije a mi esposa dónde íbamos.
I go into the men's room just to wash my hands.
Entro al baño de los hombres solamente para lavarme las manos.
The Holy Ghost says, I want you to pray for the man who owns this restaurant.
Y el Espíritu Santo me dice, yo quiero que tú ores por el hombre que es el dueño de este restaurante.
I come back and sit down with my wife.
Yo regreso y me siento con mi esposa y sentado ahí.
She said, what's the matter?
Ella pregunta, ¿qué pasa?
I said, I got to pray for the guy who owns this restaurant. He's sitting there with his whole family right now.
Y yo debo de orar por el hombre que es el dueño de este restaurante y él está ahí sentado con toda su familia ahorita.
I don't know why I just need to go over there and just start praying or wait for.
Yo no sé si debería de ir allá y empezar a orar o preguntar o qué onda.
So when I got up to pay, he got up to take my money.
Entonces cuando yo me levanté para pagar, él se levantó para agarrar mi dinero.
So when he handed my change to me,
cuando él me dio mi cambio a mí,
I reached across the counter.
Yo
me agarré
su mano.
I walked him all the way down to the end of the counter.
We're
standing face to face.
Estamos frente a frente.
Restaurant with people there.
His whole family right here. Su familia está ahí.
And I said,
y yo dije,
the Holy Ghost told me to pray for you.
El Espíritu Santo me dijo que ore por ti.
He said, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, right? I said yes.
Dios el Padre, Dios el Hijo, y Dios el Espíritu Santo, correcto. ¿Y sabes qué? Y yo oré por él.
You know what?
¿Sabes qué?
I didn't pray silently, I prayed out loud.
Yo no oré silenciosamente, yo oré en voz alta.
He said, thank you,
y él dijo, gracias, gracias, gracias.
Now, how did I know to do that?
¿Cómo yo sabía hacer eso?
Was I just trying to be a nice guy?
¿Yo estaba tratando de ser un hombre bueno?
No, the Holy Ghost
no, el Espíritu
spoke
Santo
to me
habló
and told
conmigo
me.
Y me dijo.
Amen. Now, what could I do?
¿Qué podía
I got
hacer?
A choice.
Yo tengo que escoger.
I can either do it and be obedient.
Yo puedo ir y hacerlo y ser obediente.
Or I can walk out of there.
O puedo
excuse
salir
me.
De ahí.
I will know the opportunity
y,
never
y
came.
Dar, y dar la excusa de que la oportunidad nunca se presentó.
Now.
Ahora,
it's not the end of the story.
Ese no es el final de la historia.
My wife and I, we got in the car about 6 o'clock or 6:30.
Mi esposa y yo nos metimos en el carro como a las 6, 6 y media de la tarde.
And our son is buying a house. And
y nuestro hijo está comprando
said,
una
we'll
casa.
I said, we'll just drive by and see if the people are still in the house.
Y yo le dije, vamos a pasar por ahí para ver si las otras personas todavía están ocupando la casa.
I'm riding down the street.
Y yo estoy manejando por la calle.
And my wife says, hey!
Y mi esposa dice,
she saw this girl that we know. She's got spinal bifida, born with spinal bifida.
Vio esa mujer que nosotros conocemos. Ella tiene espina bífida.
I said, where?
Y estado en
she
una
said,
silla de ruedas toda su vida.
In her home.
Yo le dije, ¿dónde? ¿A dónde? Entonces estaba ella frente de su casa.
So I go down
entonces
and turn around
yo me doy
and come
vuelta
back.
Y me regreso.
And she looks at my wife.
Y ella mira a mi esposa.
She said, how did you know?
Y ella dice, ¿cómo tú sabes?
How did you know?
¿Cómo es que tú sabes?
I'm sitting here.
Yo estoy sentada aquí.
Crying out to God.
Clamándole a Dios.
God, send somebody.
Manda a alguien.
I need some hope.
Necesita esperanza.
About Kenny Green.
Necesito esperanza.
It's his word, hope.
Ese es su palabra de Kenny Green.
How did you know?
¿Cómo es que tú supiste?
How did you know?
¿Cómo es que tú supiste?
I didn't know, but the Holy Ghost did.
Yo no sabía, pero el Espíritu Santo sí sabía. Dice que Él dirigirá tu camino.
She hugged my wife and cried and cried and hugged and hugged.
Ella abrazó a mi esposa y lloró y lloró y lloró y lloró.
She saw God answer her prayer.
Ella vio como Dios respondió su oración.
We anointed her with oil.
La ungimos con aceite.
Prayed for her.
Oramos por ella.
She didn't come up out of the wheelchair.
Ella no se levantó de esa silla, pero está bien.
That's okay.
Eso está bien.
She is going to come up out of the
wheelchair. Pero sí se va a levantar de esa silla.
Amen. My wife, this is what my wife said.
Eso es lo que mi esposa dijo.
She said she really didn't believe, did she?
Ella de verdad no creía,
I said,
¿verdad?
It doesn't matter.
Dice, no importa.
We did.
Nosotros sí creíamos.
Amen. So what am I telling you?
¿Qué es lo que yo te estoy diciendo a ti?
If you're obedient in one thing,
si tú eres obediente en una cosa,
that was just a test.
Eso solamente fue una prueba.
The well, man.
El
the businessman was a test.
El negocio fue solamente
it was a test.
Una prueba.
If you pass the test,
si tú pasas
you
la
get
prueba,
to go pray for spinal bifida. You get to bring hope to someone else.
Traerle esperanza a alguien más.
You understand?
¿Tú entiendes?
Amen. How many times we miss God?
¿Cuántas veces nosotros no escuchamos a Dios?
Do this,
no, no
I,
puedo hacer
I'd
esto.
I'd be ashamed of this.
No,
he tells me, I can't be ashamed. Yeah. Yeah. Says you won't be ashamed.
Dice de que no te avergüences.
There's been times I've been ashamed.
Han habido momentos que yo
you
me he avergonzado. Y tú también has pasado por esos tiempos.
You say, well, I miss God.
Dices,
you didn't
bueno,
just
no
miss God. I didn't just miss
no
God.
Yo
we missed the opportunity
Dios,
for somebody.
Perdimos la oportunidad por alguien.
Right? Amen. Says we're not ashamed.
Que no nos avergoncemos.
Because this is the power.
Porque este es el poder de Dios.
So what the Bible says.
Eso es lo que dice la Biblia.
We partake of the afflictions.
Nosotros tenemos que pasar por las aflicciones.
We'll not be ashamed.
Participar de las aflicciones, pero no nos vamos a avergonzar.
I had a man tell me I was working for him.
Yo tuve un hombre que me dijo a mí, yo estaba trabajando por él.
And I was trying to witness to him.
Y yo estaba tratando de testificarle a él.
He called me an idiot.
Él me llamó a mí un idiota.
For believing this word.
Por creer esta palabra.
Hell got a hold of him.
El infierno lo agarró, lo sacudió.
He hated my guts.
Él odió mis agallas.
Just because.
Solamente porque.
Of this Jesus.
Este Jesús.
Hated my guts.
Me odió.
Said I was stupid.
Dijo que yo era estúpido e ignorante.
This Bible.
Por creer esta Biblia.
No.
No.
I didn't tell him, but he's the one who's stupid and ignorant.
Yo no le dije porque él es el que es estúpido y ignorante por no creer.
Amen. He just condemned himself.
Se acaba de condenar a sí mismo.
Amen. And let's go to Luke 9. Just
vamos,
a couple more. These are y'all getting some.
Vamos a Lucas 9.
Luke 9. See, we're looking. This is the power of God.
Este es el
it
poder
tells
de
us
Dios.
Something in Luke 9:43.
En Lucas 9:43.
And they were all amazed at the mighty power of God.
Y todos se admiraban de la grandeza de Dios.
We need some people amazed at the mighty power
nosotros
of God.
Nosotros necesitamos algunos que se admiren por la grandeza de Dios.
When we're seeing some things that are happening.
Cuando nosotros estamos viendo algunas cosas que están pasando.
We need to say it's the mighty power of God.
Nosotros debemos de decir, esa es la grandeza, el poder grandioso de Dios.
Can I tell you something?
¿Te puedo decir algo?
The more intent the Holy Ghost gets involved in your life.
Entre haya más involucración del Espíritu Santo en tu vida.
The more you got to be separated from the world.
Yes.
Más tendrás que ser separado del mundo.
When people say, "I want to be spiritual."
Cuando la gente dice, "Yo quiero ser espiritual."
What are you going to do when your family says?
Cuando, ¿qué vas a decir cuando tu familia dice, yo no quiero nada que ver contigo?
I had a sister-in-law.
Yo tuve una, la esposa de mi hermano.
She said, why are you the way you are?
Y me preguntó, ¿por qué
you're
tú eres
the only one the family.
Tú eres el único en la familia.
That acts the way you do.
Que actúa la manera que tú
you know
actúas.
How I was baptized
yo,
in the Holy Ghost.
¿Sabes
and I got crazy for
así,
Jesus.
Pues
still am
bautizada,
crazy for Jesus.
Fui bautizado en el Espíritu Santo y soy loco por Jesús y sigo siendo loco por Jesús.
I'm tell you something.
Te voy a decir algo.
Your family
tu familia
is looking for you to get crazy about Jesus.
Está mirándote a ti amen. Para que tú te vuelvas loco por Jesús.
Amen. Amen. You know why?
¿Sabes por qué?
I was the first one in my family
yo
that we know of
en mi familia que nosotros
that ever received the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Que haya recibido el bautismo del Espíritu
you
Santo.
You too. My wife. Same.
Mi esposa también.
Right here is four.
Aquí hay
first,
cuatro.
You?
Yeah.
John?
Yeah.
Juan?
Many of us right here. First ones in our family.
Los primeros en nuestra familia.
And she says, why are you the way you are?
Y ella me pregunta, ¿por qué tú eres la manera
you know
que tú eres? ¿Sabes lo que yo le dije?
I said, I'm the way I am because I want to be this way.
I've
been the other way.
Yo
I don't want to be this way.
Ahora quiero ser de esta manera.
But guess what?
Pero ¿sabes qué?
I got contagious.
Y yo me volví contagioso.
My brother next to me.
Mi hermano.
He got baptized in the Holy Ghost.
Él fue bautizado en el Espíritu Santo.
But he didn't just get baptized
pero
in the Holy Ghost.
Pero él no solamente fue bautizado en el Espíritu Santo.
He was a boiler maker and got asbestosis lung cancer.
Él tenía asbestos y tenía cáncer en los pulmones.
We were praying, my wife and
nosotros estábamos orando,
myself,
mi esposa
his
y yo,
wife and him,
su esposa y él.
Been praying for hours.
Habíamos estado orando por
so
horas.
2:30, 3:00 in the morning.
Como a las 2:30, 3 de la madrugada.
Some,
yo pongo mano sobre
bam.
Él y cae.
Hits the floor.
Él cae en la
boca
y agarra su pecho.
Hey, my God, I'm burning up. I'm burning
Dios,
up.
Dios,
I'm on
quemando,
fire.
Me está quemando. Estoy en fuego. Estoy
I'm
en
burning.
Llamadas, estoy
I'm burning.
Estoy en fuego.
Don't you understand? I'm burning.
Que no entienden. Yo
I'm
estoy
on
en
fire.
Fuego.
I'm burning.
Estoy en fuego.
God burned.
Y Dios quemó
cancer out of his
el cáncer
lungs.
De sus pulmones.
We shared that with you or you, some of y'all, Dawn.
Yo he compartido eso.
Amen.
Dan compartió eso.
TV, the Boilermaker Union was going to put him on disability for he had cancer.
Él tenía cáncer, le iban a poner la unión, la iban a poner en desabilidad. Si yo tomo ese cheque de desabilidad, yo me voy a morir con cáncer.
No, you keep your money. I'm going to go to Jesus.
Tu dinero, yo voy a ir a Jesús.
Getting healed is better than getting a check.
Getting healed from lung cancer is better than getting a check. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. You don't think he's ashamed to tell? He's not ashamed.
¿Tú crees de que él tiene vergüenza de decir?
Look at Robert back there.
Mira Roberto.
Now he got born again.
La noche que él nació de nuevo, esa misma noche también fue sano.
God didn't save him.
No solamente lo salvó.
He showed my wife.
Sino que también le enseñó a mi esposa.
God, did God heal you that night?
¿Dios te sanó esa noche?
He didn't just get born again.
Él no solamente fue salvo.
Now he becomes crazy for
ahora Jesus. Se vuelve loco por Cristo.
But not only my brother.
No solamente mi hermano.
But all my sisters.
Pero todas mis hermanas.
My mama.
Mi mamá.
And own and sister-in-laws.
Y todas las esposas de mis hermanos y los esposos de mis hermanas y los sobrinos y todo el mundo.
Getting baptized in the Holy Ghost.
Bautizándose en el Espíritu Santo.
Now they can't say,
ahora
why
no pueden
are you the way
decir,
you are? Why are we the way we are?
Que tú eres, sino porque ahora somos la manera que somos.
So you don't have to be ashamed.
No debes de avergonzarte.
Never be ashamed.
Nunca, nunca te avergüences.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus.
Alabado sea tu nombre, Jesús.
It's getting hot in here.
Está bien caliente aquí.
You're in Luke 9. Go to Luke 22. Just a couple more of these. Luke 22.
Vamos a Lucas 22.
It tells us in Luke 22:69.
Nos dice en Lucas 22:69.
Luke
22:69.
Some of y'all still turning. Look at this.
Mira esto.
We say. We said, where is Jesus?
Nosotros decimos, ¿a dónde está Jesús?
I want us to change. I'm going to change. Y'all help me
change.
Yo
voy a cambiar. Ustedes ayúdenme a mí a cambiar.
I want you to change.
Yo quiero que tú cambies.
Your confession.
Tu confesión y yo voy a cambiar mi confesión.
I say it and you say it.
Yo lo digo y tú lo
dices. But we don't say it complete.
Pero no lo decimos completamente. ¿A dónde está Jesús?
He's sitting at the right hand of the Father.
Él está sentado a la diestra del Padre.
You go and get this scripture right here.
Pero tú ve y agarra esa escritura aquí.
It says, hereafter shall the Son of Man sit on the right hand of the power of God.
Pero desde ahora el Hijo del Hombre se sentará a la diestra del poder de Dios.
Hallelujah. That's worth the price of admission right there.
Eso vale el precio de admisión ahí.
Next time, if I don't say that right,
si yo no digo eso correctamente, tú corrígeme.
He's not just sitting
no
in the right hand.
Está parado,
he's
sitting a la
the right
del
hand
padre,
of the power
sino que
of God.
El poder de Dios.
Because yes. Yes. We just saw in Corinthians where Christ is the power.
Porque acabamos de ver en Corintios donde Cristo es el poder.
The right hand is the hand of power.
En la mano derecha es la mano de poder. Right. Es la bendición. Right. La mano de bendición.
He's sitting there.
Él está sentado ahí. Donde el poder está.
We say in the name of Jesus,
y nosotros decimos en el nombre de Jesús, el que está sentado en la diestra del Padre, en el poder de Dios.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Is that good or is that good?
Eso es bueno, es bueno.
Better and better. On the right hand, yeah. What did I say? Okay, so thank you. On the right hand. Okay.
Se sienta a la diestra. A la diestra.
Amen. On the right hand.
A la diestra.
Amen. So you got to get it right.
Lo tienes que decir correctamente.
One little bitty word.
Una sola palabra.
And it says, it does. Amen. Thank you, Mom. Now let's go to 1 Peter 1 and 5. Just
ahora vamos a 1 de Pedro 1 y 5.
These last two are
estos últimos
are powerful.
Dos son poderosos.
1 Peter.
Primera de Pedro.
Okay, 1 Peter 1 and 5.
Primera de Pedro 1, 5.
Now, you want to know how you're kept?
¿Tú quieres saber cómo estás guardado?
1 Peter 1 and 5 is going to tell us.
Primera de Pedro 1 y 5 nos va a decir.
1 Peter 1 and 5.
Primera de Pedro 1 y 5.
It says, I had to go back and find out
yo tuve que regresar y
who
darme cuenta
this verse is talking. It doesn't tell you in verse 5.
¿De quién este versículo está hablando?
It
porque no te dice el versículo 5, solamente dice un comentario.
You got to go back to verse 2.
Tú tienes que regresar al versículo 2.
And it tells you who verse 5 is talking about.
¿De quién está hablando el versículo Los elegidos.
This is who five is talking about.
The elect, you are kept
by the power of God.
Guardados por el poder de Dios.
How?
¿Cómo?
Through faith.
Mediante la fe.
Unto salvation.
Para alcanzar la salvación. Gracias, Señor.
Who are kept by the power of God through faith.
Guardados por el poder de Dios mediante la fe.
How long?
¿Por cuánto tiempo?
To be revealed in the last time.
Para ser manifestada en el tiempo
postrero.
Y yo creo que eso está diciendo esto. Los elegidos en los últimos tiempos van a ver y van a ser usados y que las manifestaciones del poder de Dios.
Amen. I believe that's a right interpretation for that.
Yo creo que es la correcta interpretación.
The elect.
De 1 a 5 los elegidos.
Now listen.
Ahora escucha.
This is the cherry on top I'm fixing to give you.
Esta es la cereza que está arriba.
It's going to be found. Go to 2 Corinthians.
Se va a encontrar en 2 de Corintios.
2 Corinthians. This
regresa
is the last,
a segunda
this
de
is
Corintios.
The last verse I want to use tonight.
Este es el último versículo que quiero usar
you,
esta noche.
If you don't shout on this one,
si tú no gritas y te exhortas en esto, entonces es mejor hacer un hoy y ponerte en él.
2 Corinthians chapter 13.
Segunda de Corintios, capítulo 13.
2 Corinthians.
Segunda de Corintios.
13.
13.
Verse 4.
Versículo 4.
Are you there?
¿Estás ahí?
You ready?
Escucha.
This is gooder than good right here.
Esto es mejor que mejor.
For though he was crucified through weakness.
Porque aunque fue crucificado en debilidad.
This is talking about Jesus.
Estamos hablando de Jesús.
He was crucified.
Él fue crucificado en debilidad.
Yeah.
Vive.
Yeah.
Vive.
He liveth.
Vive.
How?
¿Cómo?
By the
por
power
el poder de Dios.
We're not through. We're
y
not
hemos
through.
Terminado.
Listen to the last part of that.
Y escucha lo último
for
de eso.
We also
pues también nosotros
are weak in him.
Somos débiles en
but
él.
We shall
pero vivemos
with him
con él
by the
por
power
el poder
of God
de Dios
toward you,
para con vosotros.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Señor.
Jesus lives by the power of God.
Jesús vive por el poder de Dios. Nosotros vamos a vivir por el poder de Dios.
Is that good?
¿Es bueno?
That makes you put your chest out.
Eso hace de que te pongas de pecho así.
I shall
te cuadres. Yo voy a vivir por el poder de Dios.
When we say in Corinthians.
Cuando nosotros decimos en Corintios.
Death, where's your sting?
Donde muerte, ¿dónde está tu mordida?
Grave, where's your victory?
Lost. Tumba, ¿dónde está tu victoria?
The power of God.
Está perdido a través del poder de Dios.
This time, a saint of God dies around us.
La próxima vez de que un santo de Dios se muera alrededor de nosotros.
We say, well, they live. They're alive.
Ellos viven. Ellos
let's
están
take it
vivos.
To where it's supposed to be.
Vamos a tomarlo donde tenemos que
they're
ir.
Alive
ellos están vivos en el poder de Dios.
That was greater than the death that they
que
went through.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
That's great power right there.
Es el gran poder.
Weakness of death.
Debilidad de muerte.
And the power
en poder
life.
De vida.
The power of God.
El poder de Dios.
That's how Jesus got up from after 3 days.
Así es como Jesús se levantó después de 3 días.
The power of God.
Por el poder de Dios.
When we pass from here
y cuando nosotros
there,
nos pasemos de aquí para
no
allá, no tenemos poder
we,
en nosotros mismos.
We can't
nosotros
even
estamos
get
tan
up.
Débiles que ni siquiera nos podemos levantar.
When my daddy died.
Cuando mi papá se murió.
He died on my birthday.
Se murió en mi cumpleaños.
I walked up to that casket.
Y yo me acerqué a esa tabú.
I pointed my finger at my dead
y
daddy.
Yo apunté a mi papá.
I said, you didn't give me much of a birthday present.
Y yo le dije, no me diste un buen regalo.
And I said, just for that.
Y yo dije, solamente por eso.
You go, I want you to get up from there.
Yo quiero que te levantes de ahí.
And we're going to go fishing.
Y vamos a ir a pescar.
You know what he did?
¿Sabes lo que él hizo?
Nothing.
Nada.
He didn't have any power
él no
to wink at
poder,
me. He didn't have enough power to smile.
Él no tenía
he didn't have enough power to do
él no tenía
he couldn't even breathe. He didn't have enough
respirar.
Power in his body to
él
even
no
breathe.
Tenía poder en su cuerpo, ni siquiera para respirar.
But he had the power of God.
Pero él tenía el poder de Dios.
To live.
Para vivir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You need to get that verse and put it in your pocket.
Debes de agarrar ese versículo y guardártelo en tu corazón.
Say, yeah, one of these days I'm gonna die.
Uno de estos días yo voy a morir.
In my weakness.
En mi debilidad.
But she came in here a while ago.
Cuando ella entró, ya en sus tiempos, así es como ella entró.
She's just laying in to anybody who was available. Sister Vivian was available.
Yes, she was.
She was so weak.
Estaba ella tan débil.
Weak.
Débil.
We prayed.
Nosotros oramos.
As she stands here,
ahora está parada aquí, en el poder de Dios.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Those lungs are working by the power of God.
Esos huesos están trabajando por el poder de Dios.
He can handle the grief by the power of God.
Él puede aguantar el luto por el poder de Dios.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Gloria a Dios.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
We're not in this thing by ourselves.
No estamos en esto solos.
He didn't leave us to ourselves.
Él no nos dejó solos.
The devil. Listen,
el diablo.
You know what I'm saying? The devil has power.
Tú entiendes de que el diablo sí tiene poder.
But he don't have all power.
Pero no tiene todo poder.
He only has what God lets him have.
Solamente
amen.
Tiene lo que Dios le deja tener.
Every time I look at my battery.
Cada vez que yo veo mi batería.
I don't know how much voltage I got left in my battery.
Yo no sé cuánto voltaje tiene mi batería.
And that little gauge tells me how much power I got in that battery.
Y es eso que está esa cosa me dice cuánto es.
When it starts out, it's like this over here.
Cuando empieza está aquí el
I
la
say,
aguja
yeah, that's
está
the devil's
aquí.
Power right there.
Ese es el poder
then all of a sudden
del diablo
goes,
ahí.
I give it a little gas.
Y entonces le doy gas y se va
that
hasta arriba.
Voltage meter goes
y entonces
way
el voltaje se va hasta bien alto.
That's the power of God.
Y yo digo ese es el poder de Dios ahí.
The greater power.
El poder más grande.
He charges my battery every day.
Él carga mi batería todos los días.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias,
don't get anything out of this.
¿Ustedes han recibido algo de esto?
Hallelujah. The power
Hallelujah.
Of God.
El poder de Dios.
Hallelujah. Go ahead, Mom. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Father, I want to thank you for touching
Padre, te
Sister Bianca's body.
Por haber tocado
I want to
cuerpo.
Thank you that the power of
gracias,
God came upon
poder
her in her and through her.
Lord,
she is your daughter, your child. And I thank you that she stands here interpreting by the power of God that was greater than the sickness and the infirmity that tried to take her out.
Deshabilitarla.
Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise you, Jesus. Anybody desire prayer?